Guys, this is part two in the series for the Russian alternative miniatures. This one happens to be the what do they call it? It is the Barbarian of Wasteland Hero. There it is, right there. That's the picture on it. Now, when I'm looking at this, it's definitely a good paint job. Don't get me wrong. Whoever did that paint job is very, very good. But I'm going to take a little bit of a different esque take. He's kind of got a lot of gore on him and stuff. You probably can't see it. I'm going to do a little more clean. I'm not a big fan of gore on models because it just makes things look messy, if you ask me, from a distance. So I'm going to do some pretty basic type stuff on him. Now, I already put this a wash on him. That was just to show the detail. But we need to concentrate on the flesh. So the flesh is going to be done using quite a few different things. We're going to come in with our mixes between Acadian flesh and then the Cardic, if I'm saying that right, flesh from P3. Okay, this is going to be kind of our base. This is going to be our highlight right here. Very pink in the scheme. And to put an undertone to that, what I'm going to do is we're actually going to start off with a little bit of burnt umber as a base coat for the flesh. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this guy and I'm going to lean him so that he is facing away from me, and I'm going to airbrush in this direction at kind of a tangential trajectory so that all the stuff on the bottom gets hit, almost like the opposite of doing a highlight. Okay, I'm doing a shadow, and there is going to be some overspray that's going to get onto the rest of flesh and everything else, but all the dark stuff's going to get a very nice deep color so that when you go in with the other colors here that lay down your base color, then start with your highlights, you'll have a shadow already in there, so you really just got to highlight everything. All right? So that's the basic scheme for the flesh. Once we got the flesh on, we're going to do a very standard chaos type thing, which is going to be red with gold. So we're going to go in with a corn red. Again, I really do like this color. I know I've talked bad about GW often, but this is a really, really nice color. I need to get another one of these. I like it so much. And then we're going to come back in with P3's Cador base. If I'm saying that right, Cador, right? K-H. There's always damn H's in there, and they don't get pronounced. So it's a fantasy name. Don't put weird, non-pronounceable letters in there. Just spell it phonetically. Be more better. Anyway, I'm going to do that, okay? And then we're going to highlight, and since this is a really nice miniature, we're going to bring out the good stuff. So I got the liquid gold. We're going to be using rich gold for this one. Either this one or old gold, one or two, I'm not sure yet. It's been quite a while since I used this stuff. I'll probably have to store it upside down for about a day or so to get it really all mixed in. Anyway, and then the standard metallics up here on the sword, we're just going to do your normal metals that we usually do. And again, the horns, we're going to do the horns just like I did in the other video. And then we have some other things in here, you know, got some leather and boots and cloth and stuff like that. And we'll get to all that. I think I'll do the cloth in a khaki color. Anyway, you know, we're not going to go overboard on detail right now. But we're going to go ahead and get to the first piece of it, which is the airbrushing piece.
All right, guys. First of all, I want to apologize for the distance that I have on this thing. It is definitely a little bit far away. And I need to get my camera set up properly so I can get in nice and tight so that you could see kind of what I'm doing. And what I'm doing here is I'm just going in with a white, and then I'm going in, like I said before, with the burnt umber and going over it.
From this, wow, it turns very brown. And then as the camera goes all nutso, I think so. Not much. Very dark.
As okay. We saw, exactly I just did it to do the shadows, And now I'm going to be going in. I'm going to start off with my different paintings of the skin. This is not anything new that you haven't already seen before. You haven't probably already figured out how to do. So I'm not going to belabor you with a lot of, you know, I go in with this color, I do a base, and then I do my first highlight, then my second highlight. You guys all know how to do that. This really is an instructional thing per se. It's kind of just showing you the method that I did in order to get to there. Something I have learned that I'm doing here is I am going in with my highlight, which is a mix of the Cadian flesh and a light flesh tone from Vallejo model color. And I'm actually spraying the highlight down first before I go in and do a wash. Now, I'm only using the wash here, the Vallejo wash, because of the surface tension is far different and it's going to give me a better effect. And we'll see what that looks like at the end. All right, then do metal. And then we're going to go through the different things. We're going to do metal, and then we're going to do the leather. And then we'll start doing the armor pieces and so on and so forth. Again, you guys know how to do a lot of stuff. And since the camera is so far away, and as you can see, because I have a black piece of paper down on my board, it makes everything look a lot brighter than it really is. So when I get my hand in there, the camera's kind of fluttering back and forth. And it took me quite a while to paint this thing, and definitely I didn't want to go back and have to reprimer it and do it all over again from the start. So again, I'm just going to kind of talk through the methodology on this. So I always start with the lowest part of the model first. In this case, it's going to be the skin. I got the skin where I wanted it first before I started doing anything else. Then I just started picking out the details, whatever was closest to the model first. So if you have a piece of armor held on by a leather strap on top of skin, you're going to go in that reverse order. You're going to do the skin because it's the lowest point, and then the leather, because it's the next thing up, and then the armor, because that's actually higher than the metal. And that allows you to kind of build things up in a logical progression. So when you go around the model and you look at all the different details, you'll know which piece to kind of do first. I will say for this particular model was an absolute joy, and at the same time, it was a little bit daunting. Unlike a lot of metal miniatures that I've come across, the details are very, very much defined here. And you could really see every little minute detail all the way down to this guy. You may be able to see it in the pictures at the end. He's actually got nipple rings. I had to paint those nipple rings. They're really, really small. So the level of detail on this is fantastic. Also makes for very, very hard time trying to paint all those little things. So you need to make sure you have a good brush and you have a good control of your paint, and all those basic techniques that you learn need to be mastered in order to handle a miniature of this caliber, this level of detail. It really is. Back onto the model, I'm just starting with the red. Again, a corn red base on all the armor pieces. And then we'll just start building up the colors. After that, I'm going to use a Cador red, a highlight from P3 to highlight that red. And usually with reds, I'll only do one, maybe two highlights, unless, you know, I really want to accentuate something. So if we zoom ahead here, you see kind of it's now starting to come together. And like I said before, it's models are odd. You can do a lot of work on it, and then it looks like you're nowhere there, even if you've done, you know, 85% of the work, and then all of a sudden you're like done. And it comes together in the last few minutes, and this model is no different. All right, now we're going to go into the part that was absolutely the hardest part about doing this miniature, which was the gold. The lining of the metal on here is really, really thin. We're talking a quarter of a millimeter thick, and I had to use Vallejo's liquid gold on this to really make it pop. And the issue with that is, and I haven't found a good solution for this yet, is that the liquid gold, while you can control it very well, you have to use a different brush. So usually the brushes are kind of not so good anymore, usually go into that pile to be used with the liquid gold. So they're not usually the best. The issue is you can use a new brush with this, but it will wear your brush out very, very fast. So you really kind of have to pick the happy medium there between a new brush and a brush you're willing to lose or is a little bit past its prime. I'm going to highlight with a little bit of a P3 solid gold just to kind of bring out a few things after I did the wash. So I went in with the Seraphim Sepia wash, and then I'm going to use the gold here, the solid gold, to kind of pop the highlights. Now I'm just going back in with the red here, and I'm going to re-highlight a few things here and there. And really, the model's almost done at this point in time. It's coming together pretty quick. This did take me a long time to do. Trust me, guys. This model took a long time for me to get. I think about 6 hours, something like that. Yes, the camera always slows me down a little bit, but a lot of it was just kind of, you know, going, taking my time with a lot of things and making sure I got it right, because, you know, again, the level of detail really demands that you take it slow on something like this. Incidentally, we're going to show at the end of the video, you see I have my miniature mounted on top of a little, it's actually a tube of paste, like for kids' paste. I do it with a hot glue. And I'm going to show you at the end that hot glue is a really great thing, because once, you know, your miniature falls off, especially a metal piece, off of whatever you're using to mount it once or twice and shatters on the ground, you're going to be, you're going to want a new solution. So use hot glue. And the trick is, you use a little bit of rubbing alcohol, and rubbing alcohol breaks down the chemical bond between the glue and the plastic, and it'll pop right off. And I'll show you at the very end. So whenever I really need something solid in my hand, I hot glue it to the piece. And it, again, I like using that that thing right there, just because the tube of paste, because I could hold on to it better. Anyway, going in and highlighting with a little bit of Quicksilver from P3 and just kind of bringing out the edge details, or kind of dry brush a few things. And model's essentially really done at this point in time, just taking care of a few details. Now, on the package, there was some tattoos. And how exactly do you tattoos? You're going to need a specific color and a very sharp brush. The color that I use is coal black from P3. I think there's another color out there called Periscopes, which I've never used, could do the same thing. Now, again, you need an extremely sharp brush. It's kind of hard to see. You'll see it on the pictures, but you really need to have great control to do this freehand type of stuff. Sometimes less is more on this, so don't go too nuts, and make sure you try it out on something else first. Have another model around or something like that. You can actually kind of draw what you plan to do first on, do it a dry run, and make sure that your brush is right and your paint is thinned down properly. And don't be scared to use ultra thin paint, and just come back in after you got your shape with a little bit thicker paint, with a little more pigment in it, and you lay down the color a little bit better. But you'll see on the finished product, the tattoos that were drawn on here, I think it turned out pretty good. But again, really sharp brush and good paint control is really necessary for that, and the right color. And again, coal black is about perfect. It looks just like a tattoo is the right color, at least on, you know, the lighter flesh. It works out really, really well. So you ought to give it a shot sometime. And again, it just takes practice and and a good idea of the shape that you want to make, or, you know, whatever you want the tattoo design to be. And again, don't overdo it, because if it gets too sloppy, you won't be able to see anything anyhow. You'll notice there that I have a brown shield. Later on, I'll explain how I changed that. So now the finishing touches. We're just going to go ahead, and I'm going to dry brush the horns, because on this miniature, the detail is so good, I could just dry brush the horns. And I'm doing a standard triad that I always do with the horns: dark, dark brown, which is off camera on this one, a medium brown, XV88, a light brown, Zenduri Dust, and then an off-white, in this case, Menoth White Highlight. And again, I'm just dry brushing them, not a big deal. And this guy is about done, and I'm going back with a varnish. So quick word on varnishes, guys. Don't just, you know, spray varnish everything matte and just call it a day, because when you use something like liquid gold and you spray everything down, you know, that matte is going to take away the luster of that gold. So sometimes you need to paint on your varnishes where it's appropriate. And here I'm doing satin on all the flesh, matte on everything else, but anything that's that gold that, you know, I really spent the time to get right, I'm going to put down the gloss varnish to preserve the luster. And just remember also, the shinier the varnish, the harder it actually is. So gloss varnish really protect your miniature very well. And the matte varnish, if you didn't know, it's a very, very soft varnish. And if you matte varnish everything, you're going to find that you're going to be able to wear it off quite easily just by handling the miniature. So remember that. Sometimes people put down a gloss varnish and then cover with a matte varnish. But I've found in my experience, you can only go up one or down one, which means if you start with satin, you can go to either matte or gloss. But if you go from gloss to matte, you're going to have like this layer, kind of like a foggy layer on your miniature that's really going to deaden down a lot of the details. So just remember that if you really want it matte, try and satin varnish it first and then go back in with a matte. You'll get better results. And again, don't be afraid to use that gloss varnish on a lot of your metallic pieces. All right, so I'm just putting down the grass on the base here, static grass tufts. He's a Wasteland guy, so I use Wasteland tufts. And I think it turned out all right. Again, whenever I do the base, I'm doing a simple base. Try not to worry about it. Use the tufts to kind of cover up your imperfections. And here I go, peeling. You can see right here, again, a little bit of rubbing alcohol, and that paint comes, the glue comes right off. So real easy way to do it. Remember that. I'll probably do a little video on it again. And here's the finished product, guys. And again, I got this little spinny thing now, so you're going to see a little bit of blue kind of, you know, coming up on it. So, the Russian alternative, what do we think? I think it's a fantastic miniature. I think the detail is phenomenal on it, and I think it was great and a lot of fun to paint. It seems to be made of a metal that's a little more sturdy than your average miniatures. It's a little more durable. Which is really good. You don't have to be so cautious with it, and the little parts don't break off as easy, except for the tip of the horn, but I dropped it. That was my fault. So again, thanks to the guys over at the Russian Alternative. And I would say, I think these things sell for about $15 off of eBay, direct from the company, and I'd say it's really worth it. A note of caution, even though I'm a hack, this took almost my entire skill level to do. It is a difficult miniature paint, not because it's poorly done, because of the level of detail. So you really need to just remember that. All right, guys, I hope you enjoyed it. Again, the Russian miniature is a great thing. You can see right here in a sec how I changed the shield to the squig color just to kind of make sure it's done right. And there it is. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I sure enjoyed doing it. We'll catch you again sometime soon. Take care.